everyone. How are you? Happy Saturday. I want to talk today about concealers versus just camouflage. You know, I kind of think there's a difference as you get older and you have all those fine lines all around here. It's more about camouflaging them or reflecting them with light. And I wanted to kind of go through some of the products that I've tried over a long period of time to both conceal and reflect the light or soften. I think I've talked about that, soften the wrinkles. I've pretty much completely given up on concealers. As my skin has gotten older, I really don't feel like concealers, one, conceal, two, they all settle in fine lines and wrinkles, all of them, without exception, unless you know of one out there that doesn't. I have not had any luck finding any. So I'll go through some of the ones I've tried and what works for me and what doesn't work for me. I think people talk about what works for them, but we don't talk about what doesn't work for us. And I like videos that talk about product fails. A long time ago, and I've had this for a long time, I bought the La Mercier Secret Camouflage. And this one's the SC5. Fail. It's very thick, very thick. May work for younger skin, not for my skin. And all of these, I kind of, you know, watch videos or looked at reviews, and I just fell victim to reviews without really considering that, a great many of those reviews are done by younger girls, and you know, they don't have wrinkles, so these products may work for them. The other one is called Amazing Concealer, and it's by Amazing Cosmetics. It looks like this. You can see. And it's very expensive for this little tube, and I think I used it twice. It didn't work. I'm talking about more what doesn't work. Then I'll talk about what did work. The Dior Nude, again, not an inexpensive concealer, settles. It's thinner consistency than some of the others, but, oops, got a big glob. But the color is more like a foundation color, and it didn't do anything for me. Tissue. Let's see. This one I used for quite a while, but again, as my skin has gotten older, I'm having less luck with that. And that's, ooh, it's empty. And that's the Bobbi Brown Pale Yellow. Pale Yellow Sheer Finish Loose Powder. It comes with powder. And the concealer is Warm Beige, and it's a creamy concealer. This worked, and when I talk about concealing, I don't really have blemishes or breakouts. I have some discoloration, a little spot right here, and then under my eyes. It's generally where I tend to want or need concealers. This one I've used for a long time, and it really works. It's a conceal and foundation in one. It's by Cargo, and it's called One Base. Let's see if I can get that. I don't know why, but it works really well. I have repurchased this, and I really like this. It has a doe foot applicator and works. It really works. I like it. Let's see. I have repurchased and used the Age Rewind, but again, it just seems like lately some of these things that did work for me aren't working so much. And I don't use the sponge. I just, you know, it has that sponge tip applicator. I just use my finger. And I almost always use a brush to blend it. I didn't bring the brush, but it kind of looks like the MAC 224, but it's by Smashbox. And then I kind of set it with my fingers. This one I like, and it's pink, and it really works well, and I can't read it. It's the Dream Lumi by Maybelline. And you can see I've used quite a bit of that, and that's the pink colored one. I do like it. It does settle, but you just kind of have to dab throughout the day. These two I've had for a long time. It's the Giorgio Armani, and I think it's the 1 and 2. It's the pink and then the coral color. I use the coral color. I use them combined, but I use the darker one more on my skin discoloration, because if you use something heavy like this Laura Mercier, you just, no matter what you do, after you finish your face, you still see where you've tried to conceal. And I don't like that look at all. I don't think that's flattering. And I use the pink one under my eyes. Let's see. But I want to talk about the ones that I have found now that are working wonderfully for me. And I am switching from, or have been switching from, using concealers to using an eye brightener, where it reflects the light. I mean, it does conceal a little, but mostly it just does light reflection. And these are by Jane Iredell, and I have the number 2 and the number 3, and they look like this. And I was gonna swatch some and see if you could. Okay, that's number 2. Get a good swatch on there. You can see it's not too pink. And this one is the number 3, and it is my preference, and I use it almost every day. I have it on today. Hopefully you can see the difference. So the one I use is the one on the top. I feel like the one on the bottom can give you kind of a little raccoon look. But I have been wearing those in most of my videos lately. I notice when I do a video and I haven't used it that you can see that darkness, especially right in here. But I highly, highly recommend these. I've used them a lot. I've repurchased them. Love them. Now the other part is, as you get wrinkles right in here, just those really fine lines right around your eyes. What I've been doing is using my Armani, it's number 11, looks like this, and I need to get more of these. These are absolutely the best product ever. They work for, I mean, look, this little tiny drop, and you just get tons of product. So what I do is I take that, I put it on the back of my hand or on a palette, and then, sorry, this is kind of dirty, but this happens to be the MAC 184, but I take a fan brush. You can see, everybody knows what a fan brush looks like. And I put a little bit of the product on the back of my hand, and then I just go right in here. And it's the very last thing I do. And I really, 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 really makes a difference. If you don't have that, some of you may have the MAC Strobe Cream. And that I've done my sister's makeup, and she tends to wear a matte flat foundation. So I've used this all over her face to kind of give her that glowy look. But again, this is a very subtle, if you can tell, shimmery. And I would use that the same way. I would use the fan brush. You know, when I bought this fan brush, I thought, I don't know, do I need a fan brush? But I didn't have a fan brush. And I, you know, if you don't have one, and it doesn't have to be MAC, it's perfect for putting product in the right place and then blending it so softly. You cannot get too much product with this. So that is what I've been doing lately. That's me trying to hide my wrinkles, and that's what I use. And I hope that you found this helpful. And if you have some concealers that are just not settling in your fine lines and work for you, please share. I hope you all have a fantastic weekend. It's beautiful and sunny, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye.